Hello everyone, good morning, welcome to my online class. Students, yesterday we have completed exercise A and B of chapter 1 civics and I had given two questions of exercise C to you. I hope you all did it. Now see question number 3. Why did people travel to different regions in the past? Again, why did people travel to different regions in the past? So here is the answer. You have to write from here. Since ancient times, people travel to different regions for several reasons. It could have been in the search of food and livelihood, or they may have left their homes because of wars, droughts, or floods. Again, since ancient times, people travel to different regions for several reasons. It could have been in search of food and livelihood, or they may have left their homes because of wars, drought, or floods. So your answer is completed. Question number 3, answer completed. Now see question number 4. What did Nehru say about the unity in diversity in his book? Again, what did Nehru say about the unity in diversity in his book? In his book, see the last paragraph. In his book, Discovery of India, Jawaharlal Nehru wrote about the unity of India. He coined the phrase unity in diversity. He said the diversity of India is tremendous, yet we all the differences people have retained their peculiar characteristics for hundreds of years. Again, in his book The Democracy of India, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru wrote about an unity of India. He coined the phrase unity in diversity. He said the diversity of India is tremendous, yet with all the differences people have retained their peculiar characteristics for hundreds of years. Now see last question of this exercise. Question number 5. How are villages and towns interdependent? So from here you have to write, an element of interdependence among different communities which bind them together. The village community supplies food to other towns and in turn depends on the urban communities to supply it with cloth, electricity, machines, etc. These interdependence is what forms a link and a bond of unity. Again, an element of interdependence among different communities which binds them together. The village community supplies food to other towns and in turn depends on the urban communities to supply it with the cloths, electricity, machines, etc. The interdependence is what forms a link and a bond of unity. So that is over. Now in next class, we will see next topic. Till then, bye bye.